Right, good morning from the Hoops Inn. Welcome to our kitchen. This morning, I have to tell you, my name is Dee Goodwin, and I am one of the owners, with my husband Jerry, of the Hoops Inn. I'm actually the breakfast chef here, but today I'm going to show you a couple of dishes to cook, one starter and one main. They are a lovely fish ragu, which you can have as a starter or a main, but I'm doing it as a starter today, and you can use any fish, and an Italian fish stew. If you wanted to bulk it out a little, you could put potatoes in it, but I just serve it with lovely crusty bread. Thank you.
Indeed, this is quite nutritional, isn't it, from what I've heard?
It is very nutritional. Wonderful fresh vegetables, wonderful fresh fish, mainly from local seas.
And you don't use any fat in it at all? It's,
the tiniest bit of butter and a little cream just to make the sauce.
And olive oil, but I think that's it, isn't it?
That's it, yeah, that's all it is.
Excellent, look forward to it.
Okay, come and join us at the Hoops, I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Thank you. Right, to start with, I need to heat some pans up over here. Tiniest little bit of butter so that we don't do any fattening dishes. And I have some lovely red peppers here and some onions ready to go. We also have some fennel, which I have chopped, re-chopped, which is going to go into that pan straight away. Okay, we have half of the onion. Turn the gas up. And a little bit of salt and pepper. Okay. And bring that up and saute it on. Right, we have a little bit of garlic here, which we're going to add also. And a little squirt of olive oil. So, we're going to bring that up to temperature. While we're doing that, we're going to get the other side going. I've got a little bit of butter in that pan. And we're going to do some vegetables. Which, this morning, I've got celery, yeah, carrots and onions. So I'm just putting those in the pan there. Okay. Just move those out of the way, John, please. Thank you. Okay, we've had a little chili, which I prepared earlier wearing my gloves, because you'll burn your face, your fingers and everything else otherwise. Okay. There we go. Let's turn that down so I just need that to simmer a little bit. Same thing for this one. Right, before we do anything else, I'm going to add a little bit of fish stock to both of them.
Right.
Okay, and I'm going to add some tomatoes, which have already been chopped. Okay. And some fresh tomatoes that have been chopped. This is a tomato-based soup. Let's give it a little stir. And let it settle. One last ingredient of this, besides the fish, is some fennel seeds to give it a little bit of meat. This morning we've got some lovely fish to go in our fish stew. I've already cooked just a few mussels and left them in their shell. That's more for decoration than anything else. I've got some lovely fresh salmon, which I'm going to put on the board here, which needs to be cut into about 1-inch cubes. This is a very quick dish, really. And then I've got some lovely North Atlantic cod. You can use any fish in this. And I've also got a little bit of sea bass. Okay. So, everything's about the same size, so it will cook very quickly. This is a really good supper dish, lunch dish, served with lovely crusty bread. That's all you need. Okay, so that's the fish done. We'll just get rid of this. Okay, thank you. I'm going to wash my hands while I prepare something else. Right. So, this is going to go on the board, straight into the service fridge. That's nice and cool. Okay, there we go. Just clear that up for now. There we go. Okay, we'll have a little stir over on the stove. It's coming about 20 minutes to actually cook the fennel down and the fennel seeds. This dish you can add as much chilli as you like, whether you like it hot. Or, if you don't want to burn your mouth, you don't have to put it in the oven, but it does give it a little oomph. And I think on a cold winter's day, what a nice way to have lunch.
Right, going back over here. Let me see what else I've got to do. I need to put some wine in. Right. I'm going over to the stove. And we'll put just up a little wine in there. And let that reduce down. Okay, while that's cooking, we're going to take the lid off the starters. And add a little wine to it. Okay, here we go. And we'll put some wine in there. About one cupful. It's plenty. You could use this as a main course, but as a starter, it's absolutely wonderful. And what we're putting in this today is some scallops and some turbot. Okay, wind that down a little bit. Bring it right up to the boil, and then we're going to lower it and concentrate the sauce a little. You should be getting off a lovely smell from the fennel and the fennel seeds, and we'll just put it down. Just set up. Okay, I'll just get cleared up here. I've got a blue board because I'm using fresh fish, and I'm just putting a little fresh J cloth on it because I want to drain the fish off before I put it into the stock. Take the turbo and the scallops out, which I've actually cut the scallops in half to make it the same size as the turbo. Just cover that up, get rid of all the residue. It has been washed. Okay. Just wipe my hands down. I'm just going to go and wash my hands so I touch more fish. I'm just going to taste the fish stew to make sure the seasoning's okay. Maybe a little bit more pepper. Go. Next thing is we're going to go over to the starter, take the lid off. This looks pretty good to me. I'm just going to taste this to make sure it's okay. It's a little bit more salty. Okay, there we go. The other thing I need to put in is some fresh lemon juice. I've got a lemon here. Okay, I'm just going to squeeze half a lemon into the starter dish. There's a little bit of lemon juice. Okay, I'll do the other half as well. Okay, I'm just testing the vegetables to make sure they're cooked. Al dente, perfect. So with that, we are going to add a little cream. Just to give it a little bit of clout. Okay. There we go. And we are now going to add our fish. Shape round. And just lay it in one layer on top. By cutting the scallops in half, it means it's the same size as the fish, and it's all cooked together. There we go. Okay, just give it a little shake. And put a little top on it. 3 minutes, and that'll be ready. What I serve the fish stew with is just some really nice crusty bread. So, this has been in the oven. Lovely and crusty. Right, just going to put it on a little plate here. Chop a little bit of basil up, just put on top of the ragu. Don't get it too much, it just brings it alive. That'll do. Cut basil too much and it goes in. Okay, so now we're going to serve our starter, and here we go. Nice little bit of vegetable on the plate. making sure everybody gets a little bit of scallop and a little bit of turbo. I always call it turbo. I presume you should call it turbot. And a little juice. Is that okay? Okay, that looks good to me. Let's get a little cloth, wipe the basin down. There we go. And a little. And there we have it. Ragu of the sea. Okay, now we take the dish out of the fridge and we are going to put it into the sauce. It doesn't matter if it's mixed because it's going to come out mixed. And it will take literally 3 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes to cook. You can actually add cooked potatoes to this and make it more, if you're not dieting, and I'm dieting and I don't have potatoes at the moment. Mussels are going back over here because they are pre-cooked. I cooked them this morning in fresh fish stock. Ones that weren't open actually went out. You have to throw those away because then you could get mussels with that. Just put this over here for now and we'll be cooking back in 2 minutes time. Okay. So 3 minutes has gone. So now we're going to add the mussels. Some are in their shells. This just gives a bit of decoration. And the rest, I'm just going to one little stir. You can see the fish is cooked. The salmon is lovely light pink colour. The turbo is cooked. The cod is cooked. And we're ready to serve. Right, making sure that you've got a really hot bowl for this. And some of the wonderful, wonderful red sauce. The mussel. And some of the ginger. Absolutely wonderful. We just wipe the plate off, ready to serve. And a little sprinkle. And there we are. Ligurian fish stew.